In this video, I'm going to show you how to create your very own aromatherapy neck pillow. This particular one is shaped like a dolphin and it's filled with rice and dried lavender to give it a nice aromatherapy scent. So I'm going to show you which items you need to have in order to make this project. So let's get started. I have the dolphin pattern on the website, so you can get it there and cut it out to use for this particular project. Basically what you need is two different types of fabric. I have one soft fabric to be on the back side. This is a chenille, but you can also use a flannel fabric. And then I have just this cute print that I want to use on the top. Now you want to make sure that both your fabrics are 100% cotton. So check the bottom of your bolt or the top of your bolt and check out the fabric content, because this is something that you're going to be able to warm up in the microwave. It's filled with rice, so it's kind of like a heat pad. You want to make sure that you're not using any synthetic fabric, so just make sure that you're using 100% cotton. The only other thing that you need in order to make this project is embroidery floss or embroidery thread if you want to do the face on the dolphin like I'm going to do on mine. And you also need just uncooked rice and a dried herb of your choice, and I'm using lavender in order to fill this pillow with. So that's basically all you need. In order to cut out your pattern pieces, you're gonna cut one out of this fabric and one out of this fabric. I would probably say you need a half yard of each. You can use the same fabric and you still would need a half yard, so it's fine if you wanna use this for the top and the bottom, like just a print. But what you want to do is you want to lay out your fabric so it's all a single layer, probably with the right side facing you. And with this one, I would have the dolphin facing this way. But if I'm cutting out on this, I'm going to flip the dolphin so it's facing that way. That way, when we put the right side of our pieces together, it's all going to be facing the same way. And we're going to have the fuzzy side on the inside and the print side on the inside as we're pinning the two pieces together. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you the cutout pieces, and we're gonna go about starting to sew this in together. So here is one side of the dolphin cut out. This is the back or the chenille part, and I'm putting it right side out. I'm gonna bring my top part of the dolphin and the other fabric. And this is right side up, the print side up. And you can see the dolphin is going in the other direction. I have the nose on this side, and on the cream fabric, the nose is on this side, which is what you want, because now when I put right side to right side, turn this over. Now both sides of the dolphin are facing the right way. So that's why you want to do it that way. Because now when we stitch it and we flip it inside out, it's gonna be perfect. The other thing I did on this one, whatever one's gonna be the fabric on top of your pillow, I did the little face. So the first step before we sew these two pieces together, if you're gonna embroider a face on it, you're gonna do it at this point before you stitch it together. So I just transferred my little eye and mouth from my pattern piece to this top pattern. And now we're gonna start to embroider it. We're going to be stitching the eye and the mouth on the right side of the top part of the pillow, the dolphin. In order to help me to do that, I'm going to utilize an embroidery hoop. This is a little tiny one that you can get at a fabric or craft store. They usually come in wood or plastic, and there's two parts. There's the outer ring and the inner ring. And there's a usually a little lip here on the bottom of the inner ring. This is so when you pop it on, it can only go so far. It's not gonna go all the way through. And there's also a screw here on the end, which if you turn one way, it'll loosen the outer ring, which makes it a little bit easier when you're putting the fabric on. And then once the fabric's on, you can go ahead and tighten it back up. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the eye part first. This is the easiest part. Obviously it's a little hard here because the fabric's a little bit thinner, so it might not stick in the hoop as well. And you don't really need to utilize a hoop, but I just find it's easier because what it does is it stretches the fabric, so it's really nice and tight and you get a really good stitch. So you place the inner ring right here underneath where you're going to be stitching. So the eye is right in the middle there, and then take the outer ring and you're gonna pop it right on top. I'm gonna tighten this so it's nice and tight. And then I have my embroidery thread. This comes in a large strand and it's made up of 6 smaller, thinner strands. You can just pull it apart and take as many strands as you want to use for your given project. I'm just going to be using 3 because I want it to be thick, but not too thick. So once you have it threaded and knotted, basically you're going to follow the shape, the outline of the eye that you want to do of your choice. And you can do an embroidery stitch or whatever stitch you desire. I'm going to do a back stitch and I'm going to show you how you go about doing that. So in order to do a back stitch, you're going to put your needle up from underneath at the end of the point where you want to start, and then bring it down just a little bit in front of that stitch. You're just basically following the line of the eye here. And then you're going to go up a little bit in front of that previous stitch. And I'm going to go back down, but I'm going to go back down a little bit into that first stitch there, because I want this to look like one continuous stitch and I don't want there to be any gaps in between my stitching. So it looks like pretty close to a solid line there. And then I go a little bit in front. And then I go down into my previous stitch just a little. Oops, let's try that again. I'm trying to make sure that it stays center so it doesn't look too crooked. And then up in front and back down through the previous stitch. It's a fairly easy stitch. And you just have to worry about doing smaller stitches when it's a curved area so that it stays looking nice and neat. And that's how you do a back stitch. So I'm just gonna finish doing this for the eye and for the mouth, and then we'll continue on putting in the 2 sides together, the top and the bottom, and continuing on making our pillow. I now have my bottom half of the pillow here. This is the Chanel with the right side facing up, so it's the fuzzy side facing up. Here's the top part with my finished face, and I'm gonna flip it, so right side to right side. And I'm going to pin these 2 pieces together. And you wanna make sure, because what we're gonna do is stitch these 2 pieces together, that you leave an opening so not only you can flip this right side out, but also that you have a hole in order to pour in the rice mixture with the lavender. So what I'm gonna do is, and I usually like to do it at the back end of the dolphin, is I'm going to take one of my straight pins, just make sure this is really lined up, and I'm gonna put it in diagonally. Then I'm going to get another pin and put it in diagonally the other way in order to form an X. And then maybe about, I don't know, 3 inches apart, I'm going to do the same thing and create another X with some straight pins here. So what I'm telling myself is I'm not going to be sewing between these 2 X's. So I may start here, sew all the way around the dolphin, and then stop when I get to this point. So once you put in your X's where you would like it, then you're just gonna go ahead and straight pin the rest of the dolphin all the way around. So once we finish pinning, we're gonna go ahead and start stitching our seam, stitching the 2 pieces together, and there's going to be a 1/2 inch seam allowance for this particular project. Now I'm going to start stitching, starting at one of my X's on the outside, And again, I'm gonna do a half inch seam allowance. And you're just gonna do a regular stitch and do a back stitch and all that jazz. So let's see. Because it's curved, you're gonna really wanna take your time to go around these curves, because the neater it looks, the neater the dolphin's gonna look when you flip it right side out. So you wanna really take your time going around the curves, and it's pretty much all curved, and to really stay within the half inch seam allowance. So definitely when you get to the tail or the top fin or the nose portion, you're gonna wanna slow up and just, you know, if you need to adjust where you're stitching, just put your needle down and lift up your foot and just kind of move the fabric to where you need it to be. So when I get to this part where I'm going to turn for the tail, I'm just gonna stitch a little bit past my corner mark right here. And then I'm gonna turn my fabric and put this down. And then continue stitching. So it's all about just adjusting your fabric as you go. So yeah, so you're just gonna keep sewing all the way around till you get to your second X, and then you're gonna do a back stitch. And then we're gonna start clipping our corners and clipping in notches. And I'll show you how to do that when we get to that part. I finished sewing my dolphin all the way around except for my opening that I left. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to cut my seam allowance here so that it is about half of what I originally sewed. So instead of a half inch seam allowance, I'm gonna cut it so it looks like it was a quarter inch seam allowance. After I finish trimming all the way around, except for the area where I left the opening, I can just leave that as it is. I'm then gonna go back and I'm gonna clip little notches all the way around, except for the opening part. And what this does is when we flip it inside out, it makes the curved areas lie more flat and they don't get all bunched up looking. So I'm just gonna show you in this area what I mean. So I'm just gonna cut this like this. It doesn't have to be perfect, but we want to cut about half of this off. Okay, once I do that, then I'm going to come through and I'm going to trim little triangles here. Let me trim it on this side again. I didn't really go through. Like this, and we're gonna cut these out. And you just wanna get pretty close to your stitching here, but definitely do not wanna cut into that stitching, because then you're gonna cause a hole. So you're gonna do this about every half inch, and this definitely helps for the curved areas. So you wanna make sure that you do lots of notches. So just a little hard at this angle for me to do, but this is what you're gonna do all the way around. Because there's not really any straight areas of this dolphin. It's pretty much all curved. So I'm gonna go ahead and finish that. And then the next part is we're gonna go ahead and turn this right side out and start filling it with our rice mixture. So I finished trimming around my dolphin and cutting in my little notches except for the opening part right here. So the next step is flipping this right side out. So I'm just gonna pull it through the hole. And then once I finish flipping this right side out, I'm going to press it just to get out all the wrinkles and to make sure it's really neat. So I'm just gonna pull this whole thing out. There's its mouth. And its nose is coming out. And up here somewhere, we have the fin. And of course, the tail's down here. So yeah, so when you finish pulling this out completely, I would iron it before putting any rice in it. So now it's right side out and I finished pressing it. I have my bin full of rice here. And this is just regular uncooked rice. You can also use buckwheat. You can use whatever dried herb that you want to use for scent. Some people use chamomile. I happen to have lavender on hand. So I just kind of mixed it up and left it in here for a few days so everything could infuse with each other so the rice would get a nice lavender scent to it. And I'm gonna just turn this over so I have the hole on this side. Just gonna fill it up, and you're not gonna fill it up so that it's completely full, about 3/4, because you want this to sort of form around the curves of your neck when you put it around your shoulders. If you want to microwave it, I would do it maybe about 30 seconds at a time and keep checking on it. You don't want it to get too hot or for the rice to get too overcooked. So just do a little bit at a time until it gets to the temperature that you want it to be, and then just, you know, use it that way. You can also put it in the fridge or freezer for a little bit if you want it to be kind of cool. The nice thing is when it warms up, then the lavender scent or whatever herb you use really comes out. So it's good for aches in your neck, and it also has a good scent to it too. So I'm just gonna keep filling this up till it's about 3/4 full. And then once it's the desired fullness, what we're gonna do is we're gonna slip stitch this opening here close, and then we're finished with our neck pillow. So I finished stuffing this till it was about 3/4 full. I used probably about 3 pounds of my rice and lavender mixture. And now I'm gonna pin my hole closed so I can start slip stitching it. And because it's kind of on a curve, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna measure each side individually with the 1/2 inch seam allowance, pin it, and then once both sides are pinned, I'm going to then pin them together because I want it to be a nice curve. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just measure this first side. And whoops, it's not the 1/2 inch. So if it is at the 1/2 inch, just gonna go ahead and stick a pin in it. So it's not a very big hole, and it's not gonna take very long to do this. It's pretty good. And then I'm just gonna do the same thing on this back side here. And stick a pin in it. And now when I put them together, it just makes it a little bit easier for me to line up and make sure that it's nice and straight. And once I know that that's together right, I'll just stick a pin through both sides like that. I'm just gonna go ahead and finish this up, and then I'm gonna show you how to do a slip stitch. So I finished pinning my hole closed here, and now what I'm gonna do is a slip stitch. I'm gonna start at this yellow pin right here. And basically what a slip stitch is I'm stitching on the inside fold of my one side of the fabric here, and then I go to the other fabric, the white fabric, and go on the inside fold. It's kind of hard to see because this one's kind of fuzzy and everything like that. And I just basically, with my needle, just zigzag back and forth. So the hole eventually becomes closed. So first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my needle. I'm gonna go through this green layer here, just a little bit. Pull this all the way through and tuck my knot in there. And then I'm gonna grab a little bit of the white fabric on the other side. Okay. And pull it. And then grab a little bit of the green fabric. Because there's little bits of rice in here, you're gonna wanna make your stitches as small as possible, because we don't want any rice escaping through this hole. So now I finish with my green side and I'm gonna go over to my white side. And you're basically just zigzagging back and forth between the two fabrics. And if you do it right, once you pull your stitching and you pull the hole closed, you shouldn't be able to see any of your stitches. And what's nice is this white fabric's kind of forgivable because you probably wouldn't even see it, even if I did it really sloppy. But you just wanna grab a little bit of each side. So once you get to the other side, you tie a knot and you clip it, and then you're good to go with either using your neck pillow for yourself or to give it as a gift to somebody else. So after you finish sewing the hole, your project is now complete. I definitely recommend making one of these pillows. They're fast, easy, and the end result smells really great.